Hello there. This is Delight Channel, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative, an NGO with a vision of world transformation, one man at a time, one community at a time. Thanks for joining us this week. What would you do in time of bad weather? How would you deal with a situation in which things are not going the way you would like them to go? That is our focus for this week. And if you've been here a couple of weeks back, you know that we've been talking about organizational life cycle, where we spoke about the organization moving from startup to growth to maturity and either to decline or to rebirth. This week's video seeks to bring closure to that series. And what are we talking about today? We have focused in one of the videos on how to deal with your business when things are booming and you are growing and you are maturing and you have a lot of success on your belt. But today we are saying one thing that is likely going to also come in the course of your entrepreneurship is a period of bad weather. And the question is, what do you need to do to ensure that when everything is said and done, you are still on your feet standing? Now, when we talk about bad weather, it could be of two classes. There is one that is micro, which is specific to your organization or to just your industry. But if your problem is micro, which is actually speaking to your organization, you need to go look inside, call your team, see how you can figure out what exactly you are not doing correctly that is causing the problem. And if you need help, get a consultant to help you walk through that. What we are focusing on today is if the problem is macro, meaning that it affects the whole economy, it affects everybody that operates in that space, and you are caught up in it as well. How do you survive? Now, you need to be aware also that as it is almost certain that if you live long enough as an entrepreneur, you are going to have to deal with bad weather. I also have good news for you. And what's that good news? The bad weather also will not be permanent. It will come to pass. Therefore, all you need to deal with is what you need to do to stay on your feet, to stay afloat, so that when the sun begins to shine and the clouds begin to lift, and the rain stop and the bright weather comes, you will still be standing to enjoy the next cycle of boom. Because when it comes to the business environment, it's certainly a mix of the bust and the boom and the bust and the boom. And those who know how to stay in the game are the ones who eventually will win. Therefore, with this knowledge and understanding, the question then is, what are the things that you need to do to ensure that you stay alive? A few things I would like to share with you today quickly as I run down the clock on this video. The first and very, very important, most important, is your people. You need to do a people audit, a staff audit. Get to know your team. When it is bad weather, when it is recession time, whatever name you call it, there is no space for extra KG. You need to be able to identify what everyone on the team is bringing to the team. It is either you are pushing them with a clear performance management system to get them to know what they need to do and push them towards it, or if they are completely surplus to requirement, you clearly identify that and you do what we are going to talk about in this video with them in the manner that we are going to advise. But when it comes to bad weather, it starts with your people. Let them know what you're dealing with. Let it be clear to them what the business is going through. And let them know what they need to do as individuals and as teams to get the organization out of the situation in which it has found itself. That's number one about the people. Number two about people is that you need to do whatever you can to keep morale up. Why? When morale is down, it affects business, it affects operation, it affects interactions with customers. Everybody loses. So, even if you are not able to pay salaries, find a means of worrying about how they go to work and how they come back to their homes. If you are unable to pay salaries, if you can find a way of providing them with lunch in the workplace during work hours or during the work days, whatever you can do, your small gesture, sometimes it's as simple as even being open and talking to them and just showing empathy with what is going on and giving them a hope that when everything is said and done, they will also benefit from the business when the weather turns and the tide turns. But whatever you do, do not spare any effort in ensuring that you keep the morale up. But very close to this and important as well is that you must then exemplify and be the epitome of that situation. What am I saying? This is not the time for you to want to keep spending the same way you've been spending or to maintain your lifestyle the same way you have been living before the bad weather happened. You can't afford to be spending and traveling and just living large. Meanwhile, you are telling them there's no money, I can't pay salaries, we can't send you on training, we cannot do this, we can't do that. Even if you have other sources of income and the lifestyle you are maintaining is not coming from that business, you will be insensitive and you will be raising a band of silent grumblers that, like I said, will eventually affect the morale and affect the way your customers are served. So you be the example, rally the troop, and ensure that everybody on the team deserves to be on the team and they are contributing something to the team. That's point number one with the people. But if you then realize that you need to get rid of people, please do it fast. Don't drag it. Don't make it painful. Cut it deep. Cut it fast and be humane about it. The same also goes to salary. If you need to cut salary, do it hard. Do it fast. People can take the shock and live with it. But if today you come to the office, you lay off one person, the next day you lay off another person, what you are indirectly doing is putting a cloud over your organization. Even those who are there will not be able to concentrate on their work simply because they are not sure who will be next. Same for salary. If you are cutting, let everybody know that they need to tighten their belt. You show the example and everybody can quickly adjust. But today it is 5% off, another 10% the month after, another 5% the month after. You throw people's calculation into chaos, they do not know what to do. So cut it fast, cut it deep, and be humane. Humaneness speaks to the fact that you need to be transparent about it. Let the facts be on the table, unless you have a hidden agenda. And I can tell you, if you have a hidden agenda as an entrepreneur, you are not likely going to go far because you'll be going by yourself. You will not be able to build a group of people that can trust you and that will give you their full energy and their full focus on what they're doing. So be open about it. Those you can help, help. Simple things like giving them a very good commendation letter if they've been good staff. Simple things like letting them know that, look, if the situation improves, they are going to be top on your mind. If they are still available to work for you, can make a lot of difference. But whatever you do in the bad weather, your people are your number one asset. You need to look after them. Whichever way you want to go about it, do not toy with your people. That will be the first bucket. Unfortunately, I'm running out of time and I've only been able to deal with one of the four buckets I want to deal with on this topic. So I think it's a good time for me to just drop the anchor now. And I'm sure you'll make it a date with me next week to find out what the three other buckets are so that you too can learn and then you can apply them when the situation arises to ensure that when everything is said and done and the clouds begin to lift, your business too can still be standing. Thanks for being here this week. It's always a pleasure to have you here. Drop us comments on our YouTube channel. Drop us comment on whichever channel that you are watching us from. And if you know somebody who needs to hear this, please feel free to share. We are happy to help you as well in whichever way you can, so you can write in. And we have a Telegram channel. Check the YouTube page and you are going to see the link there. We'll be waiting to share our experience with you and help you with whatever you require us to help you with. As usual, T-Mark is still my name. And all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Bye.